I get asked a lot, and I always want to say this with all the love that I can muster for somebody, but they'll say, hey, I want to be the best speaker in the world like you, or I want to be a coach. And I often say, I think the thing you probably should do first is build your resume.
Yes.
Like, do something first. Have some credibility to your message. Say, this is what I did. The reason I wanted you on is you built real wealth as a young woman. The thing you just said, though, that when you got there, my understanding is you got to a certain point and you were like, this isn't great. I mean, I've got a bunch of money, but my life is not what I thought it would be. And I relate to that on some level, that other parts of my life weren't as rich as they should have been by the time I got to being rich financially. Mm-hmm. And that there actually became a part of me in my life, which I now don't believe, but I wondered for a while, like, was this worth it?
Mm-hmm.
What it did to me emotionally.
Yeah.
What it did to me physically, because the amount of work really required to win is a lot. And I didn't take care of myself during those years. I didn't take care of my emotional well-being. I didn't heal some things in me. I was like, I don't know about you, but I was always like, I'll get around to it once I'm rich.
Yeah.
I'm going to get to this thing. I probably should. And by the way, maybe if I get rich enough, it'll just like go away.
Mm-hmm.
So what about for you?
So it's interesting because we do, I think that it's a common thought in society that money solves problems.
Mm-hmm.
And certainly it can make life easier in a lot of ways and fuller in some ways. But when that's the goal, if it's only to build money, if it's only to be rich, you've really missed the point of the entire thing. And so I started at 19 and it was about 25, 26 years old. I had a couple commercial properties. I had a couple flips under my belt. You know, I was buying foreclosures at $20,000, $30,000 and selling them for $100,000. Like, not crazy, but just enough that while some friends were doing the bar scene and, you know, all of the golfing and all of that, I was flipping houses on the weekend. Like, that's what I was doing.
Exactly the same.
And so, you know, but I was doing all of that. And I think what happened was at 19, if looking back, I realized that I was trying to run from something, right? I was trying to become something. I was trying to, I had so much leverage of not wanting to be poor, not wanting to ever depend on anybody, to not ever need anybody. Because I thought if I need somebody financially, then they can control me. They have power over me. And coming from the childhood that I had, I didn't ever want to have someone have that control. And so I feel like I ran so hard that once I was getting there, if you will, I started getting there and having money and having all of these things. I was like, is this it? Like, did I climb this mountain? Did I get out of poverty? Did I overcome all of this for this? And I felt so empty. Like, I had more than I ever had in my life, but yet I felt empty. I'm like, how is this possible? And I had bought a building at the corner of town and I had no clue what I was going to do with it, but it was a good deal. And so I bought it. And I was driving by that building that day. I was in a black Escalade, had the shoes from the, you know, the outside, all the things that the girls want, right? And I'm like, what am I going to do with that building? And it was like a voice, just like us talking, said, put your animal shelter there. And I thought, I've never wanted an animal. Like, that was never a conscious thought in my mind. And it was like when I looked at that street and I saw the businesses that I owned and the buildings that I owned and I heard that, it was like the recognition of everything I had and also what I didn't, all in the same moment. Because while I was trying to build wealth and build the business and become this thing, I realized that I was driving home to a guy I didn't even know if he loved me or cared about me. I had, you know, friends that I wasn't even sure if they were really my friends or if it was just because of business and all of these other things. And when I heard that voice in that moment, it was like I realized that all of this really means nothing. That if the goal is to build money and have the things and to be rich, we actually miss the whole point of why we're here.
Yeah.
It's to contribute. It's to give. It's to make a difference. And so from that moment on, I took, again, in fear, no clue on how to start a nonprofit, I took every step forward on figuring out how to start a nonprofit and how to take this building that I bought and turn it into an animal shelter and start saving lives. And then, you know, we grew on from and developed a sanctuary and have programs for at-risk youth and kids that are abused. But yeah, so I mean, it's interesting when you're running from something that you sometimes forget to pause and realize how far you've come. Because sometimes those mountains, we get so focused on climbing that mountain that we don't realize that maybe this next mountain isn't for us to climb.
Mm.
Maybe we need to look back and acknowledge on all of those hills that we came through and see if maybe there's something we've missing. You know, sometimes I feel like we're so focused on what we want in life that sometimes we miss what we can actually have.
Oh, wow.
And that it might just be that much bigger and bolder than what we truly want.
Yeah, you're amazing. That's wonderful that you've done that, by the way. One of my favorite things ever said on the show, right there.
Oh.
In 500 shows or whatever it is. You know, we're a lot alike. And I think it's okay to be running from something. Like, the truth is, my main driver for many years was not to be rich. It was to not be broke.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And I don't know if that's because, like, when my dad would drink, I was worried he was going to leave, and my mom was a homemaker and had no way to support our family, or I don't know what it is. But I know I've always been very much not wanting to be broke. And so I ran from that. Many people can relate to this. I know you did too. I ran from, like, whatever bad stuff happened to me when I was a kid. I wanted to get as far from that as I could. I ran from my lack of confidence. I ran from feeling insecure. I ran from fear, right? I ran from those things. And I actually think most successful people have that in common, and it's okay. Mm-hmm. But I want everybody to hear this, because I'm writing about it right now, but I just think what you just said is so eloquent. It's okay to be running from something, but at some point in that race, you have to begin to run towards what your dream is, towards what fulfills you. That'll only take you so far. And when you finally get away from it, like you said, I'm rich now. I'm no longer poor. You go, this was it? Because I never ran towards what I wanted to become. I didn't run towards what I wanted to create. I didn't run towards what I wanted to give. And it was only till later in life, maybe like 20 years ago, that I went, oh, I'm going to both not be back there poor, and I want to live richly. I want to give. I want to share my message with the world. I want to grow and contribute to people. So in the midst of running from something, if you're at that stage, it's okay. Just heed our advice. At some point, begin to run towards who you want to become as well. And what you'll learn is that you don't have to really run towards it. It's already within you.
It is.
And you just magnify more and more of who you've always been in there when you find your real home.
All that money really is.
Right. It's a magnifier. Is that what you mean?
Yeah. I mean, if you are already a good person and you have a heart to help people, and maybe you're doing that right now in some way, like all that money is going to do is give you that. It's going to magnify it. If you're a jerk, you're just going to be a bigger jerk with money. Mm-hmm. That's really all it is. It's going to magnify who you are. And so for me, it gave me the ability to, you know, buy my dad a motorcycle and, you know, be able to, like, just gift and donate and serve and start a farm and all these things. And I think that's really where it is. But I think where people get tripped up is they sometimes have the big idea. They have the big dream. Mm-hmm. And then it gets replaced with big fear of either not being enough or not, you know, having the right education or not being from the right family. And so one of the things I did is really young, and I don't know where I got this from, but I started writing down all of the things I overcame on a list, like just literally writing it down. And if you're not driving, you're listening to this, I would encourage everyone to do this because I think it's a really powerful exercise. I've never heard anyone else talk about this. Mm-hmm. But grab a sheet of paper. And if you're struggling with something right now, if you don't know, like, you know, what is this thing for me? Or I'm too scared to do this next thing. Or I can't create wealth. I'm always going to be here because of X, Y, and Z. I want you to write down everything that you've overcome, everything that was sent to destroy you, everything that was meant to cripple you. And write down all of those things. Was it, you know, losing a parent or losing a child or being able to have a child or, you know, suffering abuse in some way? Like, everyone has pain and trauma. And I want you to, like, when you're about to do this next thing, whether you get inspired from this and you want to go create wealth or start a business, like, and that fear creeps up, you got to pull out that list and review all of those things and remember who you are. Remember that you survived 100% of your worst days because you're still here. And if you can accomplish all of that, who's to say that this business or starting a Roth IRA or yada yada, like, it's all a joke because you've got through all of this other stuff. Mm. And I think that's so important for people to remember that how powerful they truly are.
Well, you're an example of that. Again, you know, I only do one of these a week. And so, like, the seat you're in is really precious to me because there's millions of people that are now extended part of my family. And when someone sits in that seat and is doing what you're doing right now, like, I'm really honored to be doing this. What you just said is like, it makes me emotional because you're 100% right. It also makes me emotional because I know a little bit more now about what you've had to overcome. You're like an example of this. And so you see this woman who very young starts these businesses. Dad's a mechanic, mom's cleaning houses. And she just grows up to become this amazing person with this amazing life. She's gotten wealthy. She's helped other people get wealthy. She teaches people how to get wealthy. She started the shelter. She's done all these other things. Yet you had your own form of abuse that you had to overcome. I just think if you're willing to share a little bit about it, you'd give a lot of people a lot of hope.